distribution you are doing and information storage you are doing, whatever you do through your internal tools, whenever and wherever, it is known as contextual emergence. It is known as contextual emergence. When somebody wants to cook, first they are going to shop for purchase something, that is that context. After purchasing, they are cleaning, that is that context. So it is a process, it is a never ending process. So in the processing of a person's zeal to do and achieve things, first they think, then they do and they achieve. Between doing and achievement, there are gaps. There may be failures, there may be trial and errors. Even after achievement, there is verification, there is re-achievement, there is more achievement, there is multi-productivity in achievement. So it is a never-ending journey in all people. So this cognition technology will have its impact on four members of the society. Number one, see, a person who has created a new machine, he has also created from his brain. A person who is engineering and making the same machine by tool devising methods, he is also doing with the same brain. A person who is manufacturing, distributing, he is also doing with the same brain. A person operating, he is also doing with the same brain. A person who is just assembling and coming for a repair, he is also doing with that thing. And a person who is selling, he is also doing that with the same brain. That is a commercial brain. And a person who markets products, he is also doing with that. So, commercial manufacturing, marketing, innovation, creativity, adaptivity, operation, everything is done by the same brain, by the different status. If there is a machine produced, the machine has a standard. You say that MB RAM, then what is the memory, what is the hard disk status? You are just mentioning that. But human being, there is no specific such status at all. He has to equip himself to the status. So what the cognitive imbalance, it is known as cognitive imbalance. There is no cognitive equilibrium in the society. Whereas in mechanisms, on the basis of their power, for example, in motors we are having horsepowers, and electrical bulb like things we are having amps and volts and other things. We have measurements for all of these things. In human beings, we have no standard at all. It is being brought by exercises. There are two types of exercises. I have already told approach and access. Now, the same exercises. Those people, those who are having cognitive imbalance or deficit, they have to approach for a lot of techniques. So instead of managing themselves with proper way of manipulating their inherent knowledge, just giving more burden will result in cognitive loss or cognitive crookedness. Most of the people in most of the companies, even in education, also in profession, they are not given the tools for enjoying or tools for disintegrating the syllabi or the stuff. But further, they have been coercively loaded with lot of stipulations like examination, mark, certification, grade. All of these things are compelling people to do that. And due to this compulsion, being driven by a compulsion, they are doing all of these things. It will result in cognitive loss. And this cognitive loss will also result in cognitive crookedness, and it will be very conspicuous after three generations. Now you cannot see that. This behavior will be implanted genetically and it will be transmitted. After three generations, nobody can, even if you ask their name, they have to look at a machine, press the buttons and they will say. So they will become like absent-minded professors, totally de-socialized animals or anti-socialized animals. I'm not joking. It is the danger of mechanical evolution. It is going to happen. Now most of the people, senior people, they are all 40% that they won't accept. 40% all senior research people, they are having a lot of mechanical impulses inside. And upcoming people, they are having 20%. And the forthcoming people, they will be starting with this 20, 25, and they will reach the zenith after three generations. Really, I'm not joking. So this type of cognitive decline, it will be in different things. Knowledge itself is a burden and it is a problem if the knowledge is not self-efficient. Knowledge that is emanates from you, self-efficient knowledge, is not dangerous and it is productive. Knowledge that is dependent, supportive knowledge, is entirely different from external dominance. Having support of a computer is different from having the domination of the computer. So this type of domination from the external sides, that will result in a lot of problems. The problems are of different grades. Number one, even if you have a small memory loss, it is known as oblivion. If I forget something, for example, somebody, if they forget some lessons which they have read yesterday, that is oblivion. They have forgotten their mother, father, house address, everything. That is amnesia, that is different. So different types of behaviors, extremities are there. And then somebody, they are having some hysteric emulsion or some volcanic eruption of hysteria or hypertension. That is different. The same thing is in a higher extreme degree, then it becomes schizophrenia or aggressive schizophrenia, it becomes. So different type of behavior, even lack of memory in Alzheimer's disease, now they are doing a lot of researches on that. Most of the Europeans, we are knowing only one side of the European community, American community. That baseless way and meaningless way of living and living beyond the means, which I told on that global economic disaster lecture, and also hyperactive in hypersensational issues without cognitive balance, that has made most of the people are subjected to loss of memory, eroded memory, unorganized memory, undisciplined memory, and crooked memory and operations. It is more in the West. And we are following, the West is being followed by the East. Now we are developing a lot of MNCs in memory loss, in memory eruptions and crooked memories. We are developing multinational status in that multinational competition, MNC, that is not a company, multinational competition with those people. Really we are having these problems. Then, what are the four approaches to cognitive technology? Number one, biocognitive technology. Second thing is psychocognitive technology. Third thing is neurocognitive technology. Fourth thing is ecocognitive technology. Biocognitive is, they are considering that the biological process, that is the signals, the instincts and emotion transmissions that happen between various parts of the bodies, like pseudocellular organisms, cells, cell membranes, tissues, organ-specific, organism-specific, all of these things are having a wider internet or a network of communications or network of passing informations in the form of alert, alarm, need, urgency, emergency, requirement, mutuality, partnership, parallelism and collateralism. So these things are the innumerable things that are happening within the body, and this is a base for cognitive development. Somebody say that your biological process that contributes much of your cognitive thinking. So you have to approach from the biological side. Second is neuro. The brain is the major reason for all of the cognitive development. Approaching from the brain is a type of study. Number three, psycho. The impact of mind in your memory as well as the brain studies, that is very much essential and remarkable. So reading through that mind is psychocognitive. And ecocognitive, you are implanting something on the environment subtly or tangibly, and you are also metamorphosed by means of the circumstantial compulsions or circumstantial intrusions. So the ecological study is essential. And what we are saying is, unless we understand the four factors, that is ecology, psychology, biology and neurology, we cannot come to a conclusion in what we call this. So in these four major divisions, now we are going to concentrate about the issues as well as the various other possibilities for convergence, if possible, and if it is laudable and productive to the society. Number one, in biology, there is a very major problem. That's what I want to say. 100 special techniques for accelerated learning that we have already developed. I have given a lecture at the Jacobal Garudio School, the same thing. Basically, there must be a tool specification for that. I am having a talent of playing a tabla. If the instrument is not cooperating, how can I evince my talents? So, even though consciousness is having the capability of getting memory, everything, etc., memory is given only by consciousness. For even that, the productive tools and manifestation tools, they must be perfect. If the originator is perfect, if the manifester or the channel is imperfect, then there cannot be the perfection in this reality or in practical usage. So, apart from the instructor or the producer or the primogenitor, the channel or the medium and various other connective tools, they must also be in precision and order. Just as I've already told, if the strings are not there and if the strings are imbalanced,